Hey, let's keep this show going. From Washington, D.C., put your hands together for Jamel Johnson, everybody.
You know what I saw? They got butt plugs now, y'all. With raccoon tails attached to the end of them. Man, I saw this and I scoffed at it. Nay! None for me, mademoiselle. Which is very easy to do when you're alone at your house. It's the easiest thing in the world, turn down a JPEG. But what are you gonna do when that's in your house, man? You've been out on the town all evening and you've coaxed a mistress of the night into your home. And then she's like, ooh, let me slip into something more comfortable. Then she comes out of your bathroom looking like goddamn Super Mario 3 all over the place. What are you gonna do then? I know exactly what you're gonna do. You're gonna Yankee Doodle Dandy. You might dance around with the shit on your head or something. Because that's just how men are programmed. You wanna fuck this woman again by default. Doesn't matter what happened at dinner or brunch. You know what I'm saying? You gotta try your hardest. You gotta pull that hamstring. But what I'm saying is, what if that's not always necessarily necessary, okay? My question, what if the sexual expansion is too vast, right? And you never return from the abyss? Like, what if raccoon pussy's the ultimate pussy, okay? Now you've had it. You've done it. That's it. You can't close Pandora's box. You can't change the Pandora stations. That's with you. And you liked it a little more than you thought you would. Now you're at the crib Googling raccoon butts all day. Then it gets to a clinical level where you're only physically turned on by women with raccoon tails inside of their buttholes, man.